inside. Wake every morning, cold winds cover me. Because all I got is close to what could be. If you could see the light shining from me, if you could see the light shine out where you be.
That fish does not want to stop.
Take a knee and sit underneath you. Oh, sorry, mate.
I'm gonna shoot you for granddad.
Uncle Albert.
In the war. During
the war. He's got a goldfish on you, ain't mine.
Oh. Boys, do us a favour. Come one side where your lights will be behind the camera, otherwise it blinds the camera off.
You've got the camera.
Get the lights all on Eddie, and that way it's we'll get all this lit up nicely.
Gotta get it up to
it, stuck a few runs on him. I'm hoping this is one of these big boys and Eddie can get in the £100 club. And this is, as we said, this is a genuine fish. No boat used. As you can see, the conditions down there. We've been casting baits all evening and it's been relentless. The cold, the wind, the rain. But we're persevering and he's been paid off. How's your back, Ed?
Fine now, mate, Sandy.
Yeah?
Hee hee! For a grenade,
yeah, it'll
be testing conditions, this. Yeah. For
he's going to have to do this for 3 hours.
For any fish. Yeah. Any fish at all.
If I want to
it's going to take a real team effort to get this fish up and get it landed. We've got a strong south-easterly wind coming at us. Hopefully this rain stays off for a little bit.
Hopefully it's a female.
I'll tell you what, we'd all stand out in it for hours for this, wouldn't we, boys?
This will make the trip, right?
This is it.
Hopefully she'll be a bit big female. They're normally bigger, and they don't fight. So hopefully, instead of spending 4 hours, he's only spending 1 hour.
Somewhere I can't see it. He's loaded up with mono. It's a 4.5 mil fix, so it's like a 25 mil grade mono. I did let Ed have it just before we come away. It's tomorrow or shimmer.
Not a lot, mate. I didn't get a lot.
Do you know when he was going like that?
Yeah.
Right, guys. We're here on this fish. We got Richard behind the camera there just so we can have a quick chat. The lads informed me, I've been sat here. I mean, I was down there. I've situated myself a little bit more comfortable now. You know, I had a bit of gin last time off Gareth Griffiths from Wales. About having a week back, but you know what, I don't care. I've got a seat, I've got my rod set up here. My arms are absolutely on fire, but I'm keeping tension on this fish and trying to outwit it and get it off the ground a little bit. All I need is that inch of water underneath his wings and then I should be able to play him right up to the surface.
We had on though, Van Armored?
Yeah,
Van Armored, say.
We were speaking to a guy that had one yesterday, he had
193, I think it was.
And he said it took him 3.5 hours to get in. We're an hour in, and I'm already knackered.
Well, they were using braid, 60 pound plus. Ed's actually took some line, let him out before I come away. It's the Iowa Shimmer. It's rigging at 60 pound. It's only as thick as a 25 pound mono now. The knot strength ain't all that. So this, we're going to have to take our time with. This ain't going to be no quick bully it up and get it in. I think we're going to be here for a good 4 to 5 hours. We got a bit of stick last time. We can't use the boat, like I said. But there's no boat involved in this. This is all casting. This has all been done the right way. And I'm so pleased for this because we've actually been here for a good 36 hours now. And we've been plugging away, fishing in some real rough conditions. It's been bucking it down. Luckily, the rain's just stopped at the moment. And we all forecast a bit better weather tomorrow. But we've absolutely slogged our guts out, each and every one of us. And the effort's paid off. Can't say any more than that really on that, but hopefully we can see this fish up out of the water. I think you're in the £100 club here, Ed.
Personally, myself, I think pacing myself, I'd be surprised if you're not now, if you're not far off the 200 pound club.
Oh God, no, I've just had a thump. Get it on the end of the rod, Richie. See that fence on your rod. That's the pressure he's keeping on with a Ron Thompson.
Ron Thompson accelerator.
He has come up in the water a couple of times, but right back down. You manage to get one pump a couple of turns, and every time you take a turn, she takes 10 back with you.
Yeah, well, if I take 5 foot, she'll take 15.
Yeah. Don't get snagged up. End up one end of the pier, and we're fishing into what, 400 feet of water?
Yeah.
They seem to come out in numbers, we've noticed, for other people's catches and our own. You get a lot of doubler cups, so when one's in the area, it tends to be another. So, fingers crossed, me and Mr. Gigi from Wales here can see without ourselves. We're going to put them away. We've got some good conditions coming in for tomorrow. And that's all she wrote.
Listen to the scream, chaps, listen to the scream. Right, we're just getting a little bit of movement off this big old gal. She hasn't moved for quite some time now. But barely moving. But it is lifting.
Real down
now. It is slightly lifting.
Hold it.
Go on.
Reel down slowly.
Hooked again. That rod is absolutely locked over there. As you see, Ed's pulling the line, the rod's not moving anymore. That rod won't bend any further. So, can't do much more. As I said before, he's fighting this fish on some Iowa shimmer, stuff I purchased. It's 0.45 mil thick, probably the same thickness as most 25 pound lines. So to get this fish up is going to be some feat and some achievement in itself. But as I said, she's a big old girl, and she's hugging bottom. Skate on! Skate on! We're in, guys. We're about 2 hours, 45 minutes, something like that, into the fight of the skate. And I think Ed's feeling it. Say hello, Jake.
Yo.
He's got this on the Ron Thompson. He's absolutely been doubled over for ages. He's having to pull the line in because of the drag on the reel. Absolutely giving it some.
Well, I'm singing.
How are you feeling, Ed?
I'm cold, very cold. But I tell you what, I'm impressed with the line I'm using. I'm impressed with the whole setup, to be honest. I had a problem with another Ron Thompson accelerator last week, snapping when I cast. This one here happens to be the old original, the 408. Pretty good rod. Got some serious bend in that now. I think I've had whatever we want to call it, up off the bottom two or three times now, and I'll get it two or three pulls off the bottom, and then it'll take straight back down. As you can see, we've got a scenery change. We've got the bivvy up here, we got seat boxes for a bit of company. The lads are absolute angels. I mean, the wind picked up a little bit. I'm sat here. I've been sat here now for over 2.5 hours. Sat here freezing cold. There's an easterly wind coming right up alongside me. And so they got the bivvy down. Then they went and got seat boxes and sat down here with me. Rain come down, dandy. But hopefully we can land it. Either way, it'll be in the video. Yeah, it'd just be an absolute pleasure to get my eyes on a prehistoric creature like one of these.
How you doing so well so far, mate? You've had it up off the off the bottom a couple of times and in the water, ain't you? So
yeah, it's becoming a bit of a, I don't know, I just said to the lads, you know, if I get any colder, I'm just going to yank into it. And they're telling me, no, just be gentle with it. But it's kind of hard. Who's going to give up first, me or the fish? We'll see. Check back in a bit, lads.
Well, it's currently what? Oh, wow, ladies and gentlemen. It was running and running. Right, guys, not sure if you can see me very well here. Ed's just been into that skate and it's come off, line parted. Equipment really went up to it. He did nothing wrong. Put everything he could into it. He was there for it and that fish was just about. I want to go over well, a little yap with him. And see how he's feeling. But yeah, absolutely gutted for the boy. Worked hard at that. He's been sat in the cold, playing that fish for, like, say, 3 hours. But let's go over the yaps. Here he is.
Well, lads, it's the morning after. The fish that I did have on last night, I had it on for 2.75 hours and it popped a line. I got it off the bottom a couple of times, only do about, I reckon I gained 10 or 15, 20 foot of line on him, and then he'd take 40 foot back. So I think in the end he'd taken more line off me reel than I'd started with when he first run. Absolutely gutted. But it'll happen again. It will happen again. We're just going to have a last cast now. Leave him out there for an hour soaking, and then as we pack the van up and head home, we'll have a little chat in a minute and see what the lads will say. But me personally, I've bloody enjoyed the weekend. Spot on. We could, like I said, with that fish, we couldn't have done any more. The lads were there. Do I need this? Do I need that? Running around getting me drinks, me vape fag, beach bivvies, seats, whatever I wanted. They were there chatting away and helping me out. Just couldn't have done no more. Couldn't have done no more. But hey, oh, there we go. Look, guys, we're loving all the feedback. We're loving all the shares and likes and all the stuff you're doing on our page. Keep it coming. Show us all your fish pictures. Even chuck a couple of little videos up there. You know, the page is for everyone, not just for us. And hit a like and a share on the YouTube channel, please. Thank you very much. It's free to do as well. There's no subscription fees or nothing like that there. It's all free. So just go on there, give us a like and a share, and a subscribe on the YouTube channel.
Tight
lines. Until next time, lads. Tight lines.